Then he ran back to Ruggedo, but the wizard fox had heard quite plainly every word that he had said. The monkey was instantly transformed into the giant, and the giant was so big that as he stood on the ground his head was higher than the trees of the forest. The monkeys raised a great chatter, but did not seem to understand that the giant was one of themselves.
"Good!" cried the gnome. "Hurry, Kiki, and transform the others!"
So Kiki rushed back to the tree, and putting his face to the hollow, whispered,
"I want the next monkey to be just like the first, Pyrs Kixkel."
Again the wizard fox heard the magic word and just how it was pronounced, but he sat still in the hollow and waited to hear it again, so it would be impressed on his mind and he would not forget it. Kiki kept running to the edge of the forest and back to the hollow tree again, until he had whispered the magic word 6 times, and 6 monkeys had been changed to 6 great giants. Then the wizard decided he would make an experiment and use the magic word himself. So, while Kiki was running back to the gnome, the fox stuck his head out of the hollow and said softly,
"I want that creature who is running to become a hickory nut, Pyrs Kixkel."
Instantly, the Limonig form of Kiki Aru the Hyup disappeared, and a small hickory nut rolled upon the ground a moment and then lay still. The wizard was delighted and leaped from the hollow just as Ruggedo looked around to see what had become of Kiki. The gnome saw the fox, but no Kiki, so he hastily rose to his feet. The wizard did not know how powerful the queer beast might be, so he resolved to take no chances.
"I want this creature to become a walnut, Pyrs Kixkel," he said aloud.
But he did not pronounce the magic word in quite the right way, and Ruggedo's form did not change. But the gnome knew at once that Pyrs Kixkel was the magic word, so he rushed at the fox and cried,
"I want you to become a goose, Pyrs Kixkel."
But the gnome did not pronounce the word aright either, having never heard it spoken but once before, and then with a wrong accent. So the fox was not transformed, but it had to run away to escape being caught by the angry gnome. Ruggedo now began pronouncing the magic word in every way he could think of, hoping to hit the right one, and the fox, hiding in a bush, was somewhat troubled by the fear that he might succeed. However, the wizard, who was used to magic arts, remained calm and soon remembered exactly how Kiki Aru had pronounced the word. So he repeated the sentence he had before uttered, and Ruggedo the gnome became an ordinary walnut. The wizard now crept out from the bush and said,
"I want my own form again, Pyrs Kixkel."
Instantly he was the Wizard of Oz, and after picking up the hickory nut and the walnut and carefully placing them in his pocket, he ran back to the big clearing. Dorothy the lamb uttered a bleat of delight when she saw her old friend restored to his natural shape. The others were all there, not having found the goose. The fat Gillikin woman, the Munchkin boy, the rabbit, and the glass cat crowded around the wizard and asked what had happened. Before he explained anything of his adventure, he transformed them all, except of course the glass cat, into their natural shapes, and when their joy permitted them to quiet somewhat, he told how he had by chance surprised the magician's secret and been able to change the 2 Limonigs into shapes that could not speak, and therefore would not be able to help themselves. And the little wizard showed his astonished friends the hickory nut and the walnut to prove that he had spoken the truth.
"But see here," exclaimed Dorothy, "what has become of those giant soldiers who used to be monkeys?"
"I forgot all about them," admitted the wizard, "but I suppose they are still standing there in the forest."